What is up, guys? Welcome back to a brand new Dragon Ball Legends video on Dragon Ball Central. Today, we have got to get into the character balance changes, leaks, and plenty of other things that came with the most recent update. Absolutely massive changes that will change the meta in Dragon Ball Legends in the very near future. Let's go ahead and get right into it. But first, guys, we have got to talk about the sponsor for today's video, Otaku Charms. From Dragon Ball to Naruto to One Piece, they pretty much have it all. With awesome streetwear designs, exclusive merch like this Majin Vegeta pendant, and free worldwide shipping, what more could you honestly ask for? They're going to be sending me something really cool to show off in a future video, so keep an eye out for that. If you saw anything that strikes your fancy, or you want to go ahead and check out the rest of their catalog, make sure you go down to the link in the description below or the comment section below. Additionally, use code CHICKEN at checkout to get 10% off your order. And again, a huge thanks to Otaku Charms for sponsoring today's video. So guys, first and foremost, we do have Vegeta. Now, Sparking Vegeta came out very early on in the game, one of the first Sparkings in the game, actually, and he was really, really good for the time, but he got outdated. Obviously, power creep made him completely irrelevant for most, you know, teams. Sometimes he'd be a nice blast support, but otherwise, really not so much. Now, I will say that he does have some decent buffs here. His stats have been buffed as well, but he definitely is not nearly as relevant as he was when he first came out, even with these buffs in the current meta. So definitely still going to mainly be a support, if that. We'll have to see exactly how they change things up in the future and if he ever does actually find a real position on a meta team again. But right now, I don't think this does enough to actually bring him back to a powerful status and to really be the contender that he was when the game first released. So guys, Android 17 is a really, really solid character. He had a great amount of utility already. Obviously, again, as time went on, his stats got a little bit outdated and he wasn't really as powerful as he once was when he was released. Specifically, he was very, very good on a pure Android team. Now, one of the main issues with him was that his Z ability didn't buff Androids, it only buffed purple, so he was mainly used on, you know, PPR type of teams, mainly like mono purple teams that featured one red character to sort of support their use of mono purple, because mono purple is really, really solid and still to this day is pretty solid as a full team, because let's face it, mono purple has pretty much the most solo color support that you can possibly have on a team, other than maybe mono blue, but still mono blue has kind of fallen behind the times. So mono purple, probably the best mono team you can use with some red support. And I will say that this is a very, very solid way to buff him. And you're just looking down the list, you're like, okay, so some nice stat buffs we got. That's fantastic. Some nice ability buffs. But the main thing you might actually gloss over at first glance is that barrier actually can be comboed off of now. So you can get a full combo off of it with arts cards. So strike and blast arts cards. That is very, very good, okay? I cannot stress this enough, how powerful that effect really is, okay? Being able to combo off of that pushback means that you can effectively stop combos before they even start and then start up your own combos in the neutral game, okay? That is super, super powerful. Some of you guys are probably about to say, okay, Chicken, well, what's the best Android team you can use right now? That's got to be Blue 18, Purple 17, and Perfect Cell, right? And what's going to be the support members for the team? Other than the battle members, you know, the support for the team is pretty good, but it's not up to snuff with some of the other teams in the game. And while I definitely agree with that, I will point out that we are going to be seeing the release of a few other androids very, very soon. It was leaked with the latest V-Jump, and that was leaked actually a little bit before that, but we have confirmation now that other androids are coming to the game. So definitely keep an eye out for that, because the Android team is about to get a nice refresher, and I think it's going to be very, very powerful, definitely featuring Purple 17. Moving on down, guys, we have got Super Saiyan Vegeta, who obviously in his heyday was a massive powerhouse with extreme red base form Vegeta, an absolute monster. That team was ridiculous. The strike damage output was relatively unmatched at the time, and that was when sidestepping was also at its highest, so a very, very powerful strategy. Now, obviously, with the sidestep nerf, things have gone downhill very significantly for a team like that, and on top of that, it's been power creeped. Well, I will point out here that Super Saiyan Vegeta is still a really, really solid option, and especially with these buffs, having a really nice buff to not only just his main ability, being able to increase his arts card draw speed by one level for 15 timer counts, but his special move is going to get a nice little strike damage received debuff on your opponent for 15 timer counts, instead of just the 15% that it was. It's going to be 20%, additional 5%, not too bad. And also, on top of that, guys, we've got some really, really nice buffs making it relevant on the Vegeta family tag team. So All in all, I have to say I'm really impressed with these buffs. I don't think that he's going to be, again, as relevant as he once was, but is this going to be a very good strategy, and will I be trying him out because I have him at, I believe, 6 stars? You bet I'm definitely going to be trying it out and seeing how things go on a mainly strike-based team. I think it's going to be really fun. I'm kind of excited to see how he shakes out in the meta. I do think that a meta Vegeta family team will come out of this buff, and I'm excited to see it happen. So yeah, definitely feeling pretty good about these changes here. And guys, we have got the slot that absolutely 100% should have been Super Saiyan Red Trunks, but unfortunately was given to HB Goku for some unknown reason. Now, will he be relevant after this? No. His ability was completely destroyed by the sidestep nerf, and it has not seen any redemption here. Obviously, it's better than it was. This is a really, really solid buff, I will say, to his Z ability. So in mono type teams, if you're going for mono yellow for a challenge or something like that, this is a really, really great buff. You're going to have a double offensive buff by 30% at a level 3 Z ability, and then at a level 4 Z ability, 33%. That's really good, dude. That is really, really good. The unfortunate thing is that, again, with the sidestep nerf, his ability just becomes completely irrelevant. He's still pretty solid in his own right, and he might get some resurgence in usage because of this buff, but all in all, I still don't think people are going to stick to him, and I don't think that his buffs on stats were even close to enough to make him relevant again. Right, guys, so next up, we have got First Form Pod Frieza. I was really excited when he got released. I was super hyped to have Blast Armor in the game. It was all around just a really hype time, and it was kind of a letdown because he didn't stick around in the meta for very long. I believe around the time of his release, green, yellow was really big, so mono blue just didn't work out for him very well and kind of got decimated by, you know, pretty much every part of the meta because, again, mono teams really weren't up to snuff at that point and to some degree really aren't up to snuff in most cases today, purple red being the exception here. But yeah, definitely not really up to snuff when he was released. But I will say that having Anti-Saiyan 40% here is really good. The stat buffs were really nice. I'm really a huge fan of the Frieza Force teams, and you know, kind of goes hand in hand with Lineage of Evil, which again is my favorite team in the entire game at this point. Even past Fusion Warriors, guys, I have to say, just gameplay-wise and just the way that you have to play each member of the team and how well it flows, Lineage of Evil is easily my favorite team and has been my favorite team since it released. So, yeah, I have to say, I'm kind of excited about this, but at the same time, I don't know if it's actually going to make him as relevant as I hoped he would be originally in his original meta, but, like, in today's meta. We'll just have to see how it shakes out, but I will be trying him out and seeing how good he really is. All right, guys, so now we're going to just blow through these extremes real quick because I don't think many of them are going to be relevant in many cases. Now, I will say that the Z ability buffs have been very, very solid here. 26% element yellow strike and blast defense here, so defensive buffs, not too bad. Again, if you have a mono team for some reason, then that might be something you're interested in. Stat-wise, probably not going to be relevant. Moving on, though, I would have liked to additionally see him have his Vegeta family ability added to his Z ability, but unfortunately not going to happen here. Moving forward, we got First Form Extreme Frieza Blue. Really, really solid stuff. We're going to be seeing the addition of the Frieza Force tag to his Z ability, which is very nice too. And then overall stats, probably not going to make him relevant again, but at the same time, he saw some decent buffs, which is all I can ask for. Moving on, we got Third Form Frieza, who is actually kind of a beast now. And he has Lineage of Evil buff, which is really, really good. That's going to be base blast attack, and it's very, very solid all in all. I'm actually kind of excited to try him out. All cause down for assault is pretty fantastic. Starts off very strong. Damage against a regen tag team, which is going to be somewhat relevant down the line as we do get, you know, Kid Buu and other very, very main team, you know, relevant regen characters. I'm very, very excited for that. So should be fun stuff. And Third Form Frieza, yeah, definitely got some really solid buffs here. Looking through them, you know, you do see some additional percent buffs. You see some attribute downgrade buffs or debuffs for the opponent. And on top of that, the stats really aren't too bad. So all in all, Third Form Frieza actually really, really good now. I'm kind of excited to try him out. We will definitely be doing a 598% showcase with him at some point in the near future. Moving on down, guys, we have two more characters that really I don't think anybody actually cares too much about. Please feel free to prove me wrong down in the comment section below if you actually care about these characters being buffed. But Extreme Turtle is going to be a green buff here, and basically, again, going to be mainly relevant because of his Z ability for monotype team challenges and things like that. And I don't think that his stats are going to bring him back to relevance. I do think that DKP is actually kind of fun, and I'm kind of excited to see what he does. But all in all, I don't know if it's going to, again, be enough to bring him back to being relevant whatsoever. I will say, again, that these guys do have some relevance when you're talking about monotype challenges for PvE. But in PvP, probably not. And again, if you guys have any ways that you might want to use these characters and I'm just totally glossing over it and missing it, then please feel free to let me know down in the comments section below. I'd love to sort of walk these, negative takes on some of these characters back in future videos, try them out, and show you guys all exactly what they can do. But I do think that this is a relatively underwhelming balance patch, and there are only a few characters that, looking through these, are really going to be very relevant in a competitive meta sense, because otherwise they're not getting enough, you know? They're just not getting enough to make them as relevant as they once were or as they once could have been. All right, guys, and before we get into the leaks that I want to go over in today's video, I do want to talk a little bit about the Ultimate Showdown, because we did get a bit of an update here, and you can actually participate in this team-based event, get some free crystals for participating, and just do your daily runs and things like that to go ahead and knock out these challenges. So definitely do that. Go ahead, and I would recommend joining Super Vegito's Super Warrior team. So again, fight the gods, okay? Do the first one. Fight against the gods with Super Vegito and whatever the rest of your team is going to be. It's a very, very easy battle, guys. If you have any end game, you know, level 3000 characters, you're going to be able to fly through this thing really easy, especially because they give you a level 3000 maxed out Super Vegito to use, which is absolutely a monster. So definitely go ahead and join that team. In my opinion, that is probably going to be the most likely team to go ahead and get you the most rewards, because if you lose, you get 70 crystals, but if you win, you get 100 crystals. That compounds over time. So the losing team, if they lose all of them, will actually get a total of, I believe, 490 crystals, and then the winning team will get 700 crystals. Additionally, you can get 400 on top of that for participating, so definitely take full advantage of this. It's not a bad idea to just get some free crystals set up for the incoming banner, which is actually the next topic I want to cover, the leaks. And guys, credit to the Dragon Ball Legends Reddit Twitter account for going ahead and posting the V-Jump leaks for this month. We have gotten a few new leaks that I'm very excited about. Not the Dokkan Battle ones, but we have got transforming Vegeta into Super Vegeta, which is super, super hype. Definitely excited about this one. Looks like the stats, by their own admission, maybe not the best initially, but we'll have to see exactly how good they stack up in the actual game, because I'm not really sure if this is a fair representation of his stats. He's probably going to be very, very powerful. Maybe not competitive with the fusion meta, but we'll have to see. But I obviously don't speak Japanese. I can't tell you exactly what everything's saying here, but we do have a brand new banner coming out very, very soon, hopefully, that's going to feature transforming Vegeta. On top of that, guys, you might see off to the side, we have got some new Android boys joining the pack, which is what I talked about earlier on in the video with Android 17. So I'm really, really excited about that. Going to give some nice extra support to the team, which should be very, very good to have, because again, the team is a little bit outdated. Obviously, can still get the job done. You guys have seen D-Free's videos and his ranting about Blue 18. I will say that, you know, with 17 and a very, very high limit broken Blue 18, you're going to get a really, really good job and just absolutely decimate quite a few teams. And on top of that, Perfect Cell is still a very good glass cannon and a very good utility character. So maybe a really good option if you have a decent amount of limit breaks on that team and you're kind of focused on it. This is going to be some additional support, and that should be good for possibly the main battle members, but also for the support side of the team. Kind of excited about that. Don't have any real information on them just yet, but I will say that it is exciting to see we are getting some more Android support very soon. And apparently there are leaks of even another Android coming out very soon, which is something definitely you want to keep an eye out for if you're an Android player. Just save up your crystals and hopefully you'll be able to pull whatever the new ones are. So guys, that is about all I wanted to discuss today. Again, mad shout out to the sponsors for today's video, otakucharms.com. Again, go ahead and check them out for the best in anime inspired merchandise and streetwear. Some really, really awesome stuff over there. And guys, I'm super, super hyped for all this new stuff that's coming out. Obviously, we're going to be going for transforming Vegeta and the new androids. There's going to be other stuff I'd imagine behind the scenes they're going to be working on and putting out too. Just going ahead, ending off the celebration with a bang, or maybe just ending it off and then, you know, sort of giving us a new banner to start out, you know, the next phase of the game after the anniversary celebration. I honestly don't know the timeline on everything yet. We don't have any confirmations at this point, but it is going to be some exciting stuff whenever it does come out. Let me know what you think down in the comment section below of the balance changes and these new characters that are going to be released from the V-Jump scans. And I will see you guys in the next one. Until then, have a fantastic day. Peace.